Imagine a monk as the big bad evil guy. Welcome to my channel. I focus on tabletop role-playing games, video games, and science fiction. The idea is to have a monk follow the way of the shadow too literally and become an actual shadow. Okay, let's talk about what the monk following the way of the shadow and getting converted into a shadow would look like. If we look on page 269 of the Monster Manual, we see that a shadow is an armor class of 12 and a 3 d8 plus 3 hit dice, which would average out to a hit points of average of 16. It's got a speed of 40, a strength of 6, dexterity of 14, a constitution of 13, an intelligence of 6, a wisdom of 10, a charisma of 8, a challenge level of only a half, and challenge points of 100. Now, there are a whole bunch of capabilities of the monk, I mean, of the shadow. Let's first talk about the shadow. That the true, what I'm going to call is a true shadow monk has. But here's the skills for a shadow: has stealth of +4 or +6 in dim light or darkness. Its damage vulnerability is to radiant, but its damage resistant is to acid, cold, fire, lightning, thunder, bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing from non-magical weapons. Its damage immunity is necrotic and poison. And condition immunities include exhaustion, frightening, grappled, paralyzed, petrified, poison, prone, and restrained. And then it's got the dark vision of 60 and the passive perception of 10. So now, if we compare, the idea that I'm coming to is this is the equivalent of a monk lich. So what happens is that this, I know that there are some other people, but this is a shadow monk. It's a true shadow, but he's become a very high-level monk, let's say at least 18th level, and he has all the abilities of the monk, but he has transitioned into a shadow. So if we take a look at this, I'm just balancing some ideas from what a lich has. So what I came up with is that he has the same number of hit points as a lich. He's got a strength that's faster than a lich, but less than a shadow because he's a shadow monk. He sort of fits in between. So there's that. And then I came up with the stats of a strength of 16 because he was a monk. He's got a dexterity of 20, which is very important for a monk. And just like in a lich, the intelligence went to 20. So the true shadow monk has become a dexterity of 20. He's got a constitution of 18 because that's very high important for a lich, for a monk, I mean. Then he's got an intelligence of 10 and a wis intelligence of 11 and a wisdom of 11 and a charisma of 13 because he's not as ugly, shall we say, or his charisma is higher than that of a shadow. So plus he's got all the attributes of an 18th level monk. And he should also get the, I would say, the damage vulnerabilities to radiant. That's his weakness because he's there. Radiant is his damage vulnerabilities, but he's resistant because he's inherited the resistance from the shadow to acid, cold, fire, lightning, thunder, bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing from non-magical weapons. This makes him really kind of nasty in combat. He's also immune to necrotic and poison because he's actually undead. So this is, and this makes him, he says he can become amorphous and move through a space as narrow as 1 inch wide without squeezing. And while in dim light, he has the shadow stealth. While in dim light or darkness, the shadow can take or hide action as a bonus action. He's weakened in sunlight, and then he has the strength drain that is common to a shadow. So if we look at what happens, what he's got in the way of the shadow, this is in the player's handbook on page 80, talking about the way of the shadow, that he, first off, he's got the shadow arts. He has the ability to cast darkness and dark vision and so on. And he's got the shadow step and the cloak of shadows and the 17th level's opportunist. He can exploit a creature's momentary distraction when it is hit by an attack. Whenever a creature within 5 feet is also hit by an attack made by a creature other than you, you can use your reaction to make a melee attack against that creature. So unlike a lich, which is a magic, which is a comes from a wizard and is going to cast a lot of spells, the true shadow monk is going to engage in combat, in melee type combat, but he's kind of nasty because he's got damage resistance to non-magical weapons, and he's got all these immunities and resistance type that makes him a challenge in combat. Now, because he's so high level and he is the way of the shadow, at this level, he has gone his own way, shall we say. I did the video about wizard going his own way. This is a monk that has gone his own way, which fits with the monastery idea. This monk may have been in a monastery, may not be an adventurer type, have built up it in his monastery, has come to lead the monastery, and has went one step farther from following the way of the shadow to actually become a shadow. He's the epitome, or I think I pronounced that word, he's the epitome of what the way of the shadow is. You want to study and research the way of the shadow. So he's become a shadow and has all those abilities and attributes, and it fits well with this. But this means that he is probably running a monastery and he's got all his followers because they're going to try and emulate him. They are normal monks following the way of the shadow, which fits into this concept that the way of the shadow is stealth and subterfuge, and these, they could be called ninjas or shadow dancers. All of this fits into the concept that they admire the shadow as the undead, and that's what they want to become. So now, this is your big bad evil guy. He has, well, he may not be evil, but he's went undead, but he's a monk. So this is a different kind of character. Now, this one fits perfectly. This would be the head of an assassin's guild. This would be the one who would be out there willing to assassinate anyone. That he would be the guide master or guild master of a monastery of monks following the way of the shadow, which means he's interested in gaining more power and more prestige for his monastery and gaining more followers into the way of the shadow. All of it fits that he wants the way of the shadow. So I'd like to hear your comments about this one. What do you think about a shadow monk where the emphasis is on the fact that they've actually become a shadow? Thank you for watching my video. I look forward to learning what you think about this video. Let me know in the comments below. If you like the video, press the thumbs up button. You can subscribe by clicking the link in the lower left. If you are interested, there are links to more content.